What good beautiful people, welcome to yet another video. I hope you guys are feeling good. I am glad to be back with another video, and in today's video, this will be a review for the Wolverhampton versus Chelsea game, which we were able to just collect a point. And honestly, I would rather take a point than lose this game, because with the amount of saga going on around the Premier League, with the amount of cases of COVID we have, with the amount of injuries we have, they might look like excuses, but they are not. We did the best that we could in this game. Sadly, for the finishing, which I have been telling you guys about, was not the best, and hence, we just had to take our 1 point and run away with it. Sadly, in terms of Man City, they're ahead, I think, with 6 points. Liverpool are set to play today against Tottenham, and guys, yeah, it's okay. Maybe we'll just target the top three or top four at the end of the day. I mean, in terms of the Premier League title, it's safe to say it's looking a bit foggy in terms of that space, and it is what it is. But I really hope you do enjoy this content. If you do, please make sure you give me a big thumbs up, share it with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the post notification bell to be notified every time I upload a video. Now let's jump right into it. In terms of the starting 11, there was a bit of a change, and I had a session with the live with Chelsea Perspective. I will be linking it in the description down below. Please check it out. We were discussing about the starting 11, what were our thoughts about it, and honestly, I was a bit surprised. I mean, due to the fact that we're suffering numerous numbers of COVID cases, we had a limited number of players. Even in terms of substitutions, compared to the Wolves side, we only had 6 players. Now, this was really tough on us, but I felt like the players actually stepped up. There's some players who are not too good, but at the end of the day, we just have to take it. I mean, what can we do? This is our team. We stick with it through thick and thin, through tough times, and we still won. And you know what I mean? We're jumping to Europe. But I mean, we're not the only team suffering this thing. And Wolves came in this game. We know how Wolves play. I mean, Liverpool have played Wolves. They only got a goal from them. Man City played Wolves. They only got a point. They only got a one win from them. So a 1-0 win from them for both teams, so they both got 3 points. But in terms of us, we're only able to get a point. But I'll take it. I mean, you have to look on the positive side. Of course, in terms of starting 11, let's just jump right into it. For my predicted starting 11, there was a bit of a new entry, because Thomas Tuchel had to be creative. We're lacking players, so hey, he's got to step up. He had to call some players into new roles, and this is what happened. So we had Mendy in goal. 3-4-2-1 was the formation with Mendy in goal. And then for the back three, we had Rudiger, Thiago Silva, and Azpilicueta. Christensen was not even on the bench. I hope he doesn't have COVID, but he was not even on the bench. Of course, he has the contract issues, but long story, guys, long story. Now, in terms of midfield four, we had Alonso, then this is where the new entry was. We had Kante, and then Trevor Chalobah tried to play at the pivot role. And for me, I felt like he tried. I mean, this was his first time. A bit of mistakes within the game, but he gave his best. I felt like he tried. There were some really good interceptions in the game throughout the 90 minutes. There was a lot of pressing from the Wolves players. The second half was more intense, but I'll get into that. In terms of right wing back, our one and only Reece James. Then up for the front three, we had Hakim Ziyech on the left side, Mason Mount on the right side, and then up front, we had Christian Pulisic. Yes, that was the starting 11. I mean, I thought Kovacic would start, but he came in as a substitution. In terms of substitutions, maybe I'll just mention it. We had Saul coming in place of Ziyech. No, Saul came in place of Chalobah. I feel like Chalobah, you know, he just came back fresh out of injury, and then he had a bit of a collision with Thiago Silva, and he had to come out during the second half. So Saul came in his place, and Saul, he tried in this game. I'm gonna give him that. I mean, he was just passing the ball backwards. I feel like he should be more confident in propelling the ball forward, but in this case, it's better safe than sorry, and I feel like he just played safe in this game. And well, guys, it is what it is, man. I'm so frustrated with everything going on. I am sensing a lockdown coming on, and I feel like in the UK, I don't know what's gonna happen in my country, but let's see what happens. I mean, the new variant spreading. bad name. The new variant spreading is really hard and almost everyone has a cold. Bro. Anyway, guys, I mean, in terms of the substitution, Kovacic came in place of Ziyech. Now, I don't know, I feel like the formation had to change because sometimes I would see a back four, sometimes I felt like Kovacic was playing in place of Ziyech. It was a lot of chaos, okay? And to be honest, we just tried. We gave it our best with our situation. We tried, okay? So let us not beat ourselves too much. Now, in terms of the first half, a lot of pressing. A lot of pressing. So for the first few minutes, I think first 3 minutes, Chelsea was just wow. We were in the world's half. We were pressing them. There was an attempt. I think it was Byron James. There was an attempt during the first few minutes, but then I don't know what happened. I don't know. I feel like the mentality of the players at the moment is a bit strained. The whole COVID situation, the whole fact that they're really strained in terms of players. Players are playing game in, game out. And after this game on Sunday, we have another game on Wednesday where we face Brentford for the quarterfinal of the EFL. And guys, I am going to be sighing a lot in this video. So for the first half, as I was saying, Wolves continued pressing and they pressed on till the 45th minute, and there was a bit of there were some free kicks, and they were just finishing was just not there. The Wolves are a defensive team, and they were defending to their core. I saw, wow, it was just great defending from them. I have to give them that. I said this was going to be a tough game. I was expecting a few goals, maybe one goal. Wolves! I just remembered. In the 14th minute, Wolves got a goal. They actually did score a goal. And then 23 seconds later, the referee raises the flag up. Turns out it's offside. I have to say, I was happy. I was relieved. I was very, very relieved because I was just thinking, now if Wolves have scored this goal, they will lock this game. They will defend till till the sun goes down, and that is what they did. I mean, of course, after the goal was disallowed, I was happy. I'm not gonna lie, I was so happy because after they scored, you should see how the Wolves fans were so rowdy. I was like, oh, we've conceded another goal, and that goal was phenomenal. That was a phenomenal goal. I mean, yo, but thank God it was not a goal, disallowed goal. And then coming to the second half, of course, a lot of pressing. More chances to the Wolves side. I mean, and then going to the second half, I feel like we came in a bit more stronger. Saul, as I said, came in as a substitution in the second half. He tried. I mean, although he was just passing the ball backwards. What will we do about Saul? Better call Saul. Nah. But he tried. He's not gonna be the scapegoat for this video, for this game. We did what we could, we did our best, and sadly, it just did not materialize. It just was not meant to be. What should we do about it? Nothing. We take it, we move on, coming on to the next game, we come in better, bigger, and stronger. Now, into the second half, I feel like we put in a lot of effort. We were pressing more chances, we had more corners, more attempted shots, and throughout the whole game, we had 8 attempted shots. With I think one of them almost on target. The Mason Mount trial was it was okay. Reece James was losing the ball so carelessly at one point, and I was so Ziyech lost the ball too so carelessly. I mean, there were some mistakes in this game. I feel like we should look more into it. I mean, in terms of the concentration of the ball, once you get the ball, let us hold the ball. Look at N'Golo Kante. What will we do without this guy? This guy right here. Thank God for N'Golo Kante. I mean, he's not 100%, but the way he played, he almost gave us a goal. There was a block. There was a moment towards the end of the game, there was a moment that N'Golo Kante got blocked when he was trying to score, and I felt like that was a penalty. Did you feel like that was a penalty? Please comment in the comment section down below. But I feel like it was a penalty, but hey, it does not always go how you want it to, and it is what it is, guys. N'Golo Kante for me was my man of the match. He performed greatly despite his injuries. Kovacic came in a bit rusty in the beginning, but then he picked up form and he was playing a bit better. So in terms of the rest of the players, Thiago Silva, great defending throughout the game. Rudiger, I mean, when Adama Traore came in during the second half, of course there was more of a threat, but Rudiger stepped up. Azpilicueta too, a bit rusty, but he tried. I mean, this game was just not one of our best, but we'll take the 1 point. In terms of my score prediction, I predicted a 2-1 win or 1-1 draw, but it ended up in a 0-0 draw, so I got the draw part right. So anyway guys, that was in terms of my video. Now moving forward, of course, Arsenal are just behind us and Man United have not played so many games because the games have been postponed. I mentioned on my Twitter that, is this agenda a thing? Because we requested for our game to be postponed. Now there was an announcement that 7 more players had contracted COVID, and we requested the Premier League to postpone our game. They did not. They denied our request, and it's just sad. It's actually very sad. Something should be done about this whole COVID situation. I mean, why are the fans still being allowed to come in with all these players? Look at what happened to Kai Havertz. I mean, I predicted Kai Havertz to start, but then he was not able to start because apparently he tested positive today. And then he was playing yesterday with the players because he tested negative. Now, he tested negative the day before, okay, on Friday. On Friday he tested positive, on Saturday he tested negative, on Sunday he tested positive, on Saturday he trained. Now what happened to the players who were exposed to playing next to him? Of course he's not playing with a mask. So guys, this whole situation is so frustrating. I am so disappointed with how this game went, but we gave our best. I feel like we really tried. I'm gonna cut them some slack. They're still human beings. They're not in form, we're suffering injuries, call them excuses, I call them facts, but it is what it is. We move, guys. So, see you for my next video. I will hopefully be doing a preview. We'll be facing Brentford for the EFL Cup, and hopefully we do something about it, and we're not kicked out of the... hopefully we're not kicked out of the tournament. But other than that, guys, I really hope you did enjoy this video. I know it's a sad one to take in, but it happens. We are not in form. We have so many cases of COVID. So many. I have said this over and over. I think it's becoming a song now. So you guys know the facts and you guys know what's going on. But at the end of the day, it's what it is. So we take our points, we move, we try on another day. So not our best day, as the blue says. But thank you for the support and I really appreciate it. So if you enjoyed this content, please make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Share it with your family and friends. Please don't forget to subscribe. Turn on the post notification bell so you're notified every time I upload a video. I will definitely be seeing you in my next video. Please subscribe. I know we had a draw, but just subscribe, okay?